course the latter. Full of adventure, that's for sure.
Always full of adventure. I like a good balance, though. I mean, after a while, it's
true.
After sometimes you get tired. You know, I'm not a young spring chicken anymore. Sometimes
a
bit of boring stuff is really exciting for me.
Mm-hmm.
I've had a lot of excitement in my life, but I have no regrets. So I would like to have more of the latter, but definitely some of the former.
Yeah, a bit of quiet also. Yeah, that's a good answer. Excelling in what you do best,
I think also being passionate about what you do, you know, and loving what you do. The minute you start disliking what you do, there's no point doing it. You stop being creative because you don't care. You don't care. You have to care. You have to have the passion. And I think it's also being creative in every aspect of your life, not just one thing. Being a true artist means everything you do has a touch of artistry.
Mm, constantly want to learn.
Yes, constantly. It's always a constant voyage of discovery and constant of sense of improving. Never thinking that you know everything.
Yeah.
Being humble, I think, is good too as well. Realizing that there's always more stuff to learn. I think this is it totally depends on the couple and situation. It could be the one determining factor that destroys a marriage. There's sometimes no looking back from it.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, I've been in a situation where my partner has cheated, and actually, that wasn't the determining factor for me. It wasn't me that wanted to call it quits. I was actually willing to forgive that and move on because I realized the situation and, you know, and it's something that I have to work on for the relationship. So it made me work on it. Unfortunately for her, it was she couldn't overlook that. So that's what it ultimately destroyed our relationship. But it wasn't for me. The forgiveness was there. It was not about that. It was about let's learn from this and move on. But unfortunately, sometimes when something is damaged, it's damaged.
Yeah, you're right. It's hard to say because, of course, once you enter the sacrament of marriage, being Catholic, of course, being faithful is a no-no. But I know couples who have gone through something like this, and it just made their relationship stronger. So it really depends on the person, on the couple.